The gold and peach hues of this Pacific sunrise have stolen up on me this morning, silhouetting the palm-treed motu of the eastern barrier reef of Maupiti Lagoon for the last time. My name is Henry, and this is Hippolyta. She is a 1974 Maxi 9-5 in which I am crossing the Pacific solo. Through sun and squalls, calms and storms, we have spent the last 2 months travelling the beautiful lagoons and coral atolls of the Windward and Leeward Society Islands of French Polynesia. We have explored the iconic Bora Bora and recently the more remote Maupiti, where we have now been trapped for 10 days. This glorious incarceration was caused by southerly winds and a big swell, rendering the tight lagoon entrance impassable to small boats. But with the weather now set fair and the pass open, it's time to hit the ocean again and stretch our legs for what remains of the sailing season. Destination, the tropical archipelagos of Tonga and Fiji. Well, it's a beautiful morning in Maupiti and it looks like the pass might be open. And just trying to get my head into passage mode again. It's about 1200 miles to Tonga, about 1800 to Fiji. And I think the plan is going to be to head west and then in about a week's time decide which I'm going to. Which is exciting, and yeah, just back into passage mode, really. Ghosting slowly out of Maupiti under engine. Got a triple reef main up and the full foresail pulled out to the left, leaving Maupiti behind me. So here I am in Maupiti. It's Saturday and today's the day we're going to go, and I thought that it would be a good idea to just talk through the planning, and you know, rather than just arrive in places and show you the cool drone footage, to show you what it's like to sail solo across some of the Pacific. Well, here we have Admiralty Map 4007, which is the large-scale Mercator projection, so the flat map projection of the Pacific Ocean, and you can see where we've come so far. So we came through the Panama Canal and we were on way to the Galapagos Islands when we had our problem and ended up diverting to Ecuador. And then you can see the position marks, the daily position marks for my trip from Ecuador across 4,000 miles of the Pacific Ocean, a quick stop in Pitcairn, and then a straight route to the Gambier Islands, where I was going to stop and I wasn't able to, so it was all the way up to Tahiti. And so here we are now in Maupiti, which is an island on the northwest edge of French Polynesia in the Leeward Society Islands. And this is the jump here to the Vava'u group of Tonga. And it's about 1200 miles. Looking at the weather, at this time of year you've got depressions forming near the Coral Sea and then pushing down southeast, which is where the depressions go. But sometimes they can linger up near Tonga. So wanted to keep clear of that, and in the trade winds, a northerly route's probably best. And the plan is that when I get to 167 west and 16 degrees into south, which is about here, as you can see, then I'm going to have the chance to choose between Tonga or Fiji. So I'm just going to go west for a week, get to about this point, and then make my decision.
It's day three out of French Polynesia and just finally kicked the seasickness. It's been really bad. The seas are just quite unpleasant, but I've started to feel better today. I can start being able to read. Still been spending most of my time in bed because the bed's very close to the centre of the boat, so it's the place we get least G's with all of the rolling and heaving. Anyway, I've just come up to a nice sunset, and my new chum, a cormorant, who's having a whale of a time, sat on my guardrail.
How's it going? You okay? Just chilling out. Long day. You've not chosen a very good boat to be on in these seas. The wind's still coming directly from the east, which is making it quite hard to get west. But this is the setup we've been using. So it's known as goose winging. So putting the two sails out either side. It's not hugely stable. You get a lot of roll with a goose wing, which is why you don't tend to use it at sea. But it is actually just the fastest way of getting anywhere at the moment. Because if you have two sails up on the same side, one sail gets covered and you lose power, and then we're tricking along at 3 or 4 knots. And I mean, this is the first time that we've been doing sort of 100 mile days. Usually we get 120, 130 mile days, so it's all taking a long time, but having a good trip so far. The seasickness is gone, and as you can see, the Pacific is, you know, rather stunning and very, very empty. It's an empty-ish part of the Pacific, and you know, probably another 6 or 7 days to run until we're past Tonga, another couple of days after that until we're at Fiji. It's a big bait ball up there, a load of birds diving into the water, which means there's bait on the surface, so we're going to go straight through the middle of it with towing a lure, so we'll see if we may get a bird. But if there's a bait ball, there's normally other predators in the sea. So I don't know, maybe we'll see a fish on the line. I've had a big strike almost immediately that I went over that bait ball. It feels quite strong. It might be a tuna. First thing I've got to do is slow the boat down, so I'm just putting this rod away. I'm just going to furl the foresail away. There's nothing I can do with the mainsail, not on my own, so that'll have to do, and hopefully that'll slow us down enough for me to fight this fish. I've been going for almost half an hour. It's not bloody helping that the wind is quite powerful at the moment, so we're still cracking along at 3 or 4 knots, just trying to get this thing in. Little yellowfin.
Okay. Well, that's Hippolyta's first ever yellowfin tuna, right there. Nice.
Tail hook on him. Well, it's 6 days out of Maupiti in French Polynesia, headed towards Fiji and Tonga. And this afternoon I've turned south towards Tonga because the weather looks really good for it and the wind's going to carry on picking up and takes a bit faster. And I have this lovely sunset to enjoy. And behind we got big old squall. And so I'm going to tie up the canvas for the night and go to bed. It's actually going to be quite a busy night. I've got the Chinese fishing fleet all around me, although not visually yet. So I'm going to have to keep one eye open. We're no long sort of 4 hour sleeps tonight. It'll be little 20 minute cat naps and up to check for lights. And I will, wherever possible, I'm going to film it so you can see what it's like having a night on full alert. But oh, so we're having some of that fun already. You can see here, you see the little ship icon on the left is a buoy. It's a long lining buoy on one of these sort of 60 mile long long lines that Chinese ships are dropping. And the reason it's a problem is just because it's so low in the water that I didn't pick it up until about 2 miles out, and I was almost going over the top of it. And so now I've changed course to avoid it, and we'll see whether I manage to dodge it. I've pulled the tow generator out of the water because if we go over the top of fishing line that's close to the surface, I don't want it to be able to snag on anything. And the risk is that it's going to snag on the hydrovane rudder, because that's the only vertical thing which can really snag on. So I'm now just sort of sat here waiting and hoping that it doesn't hit. This is my other means of checking, and you can see here, you can see these long lines of buoys being dropped. It's about 60 meters long, and that blue dot there is me. And so you can see that I'm right on top of one, but this is the outer line, so I've managed to avoid that inner line. And if we zoom out, you can see that once I'm through there, it's gravy. And I'm probably be okay from that point on. But it just goes to show that the AIS feature that I have on my on the Predict Winds, so that's the satellite service that I subscribe to, and that allows me to download all of the AIS targets within 300 miles down off the internet, off the satellite feed basically. And that's brilliant. And in this case, it's allowed me to maneuver my way around. Somewhere out there, there's a big old buoy. Needs avoiding, and the line that's running from it. You can see that I've got the tow generator out of the water, and that's where we'll have the problem, down on the hydrovane rudder down there. The hydrovane rudder is the only straight bit under the boat, so that's where the line will catch. So I'm just going past the danger point now, so I'm just sat here and waiting to see if we catch a line. If so, I'll push it off with one of the poles I've got ready. All part of the fun of dicing with fishing boats. We're coming up to the end of the 8th day at sea. Got about 400 miles left to run to Tonga, and the wind's picked up massively. It's about 5 in the afternoon, and doing about 22 knots up the Chuff. Big seas. I've got the self-leveling on the GoPro, so you can probably see they're being chucked around. 5 hours since noon, we've averaged 6.5 knots, which is nuts. So time for the weekly chart check. We left from Maupiti, and then you got a cross on each day. Went all the way across between the Southern Cooks down here, so Rarotonga, Aikatak and Palmerston Atoll, and the Northern Cooks up here, so Suwarrow, Penrhyn and others, and Tongariro up here. And we're now between the Cooks and the Tonga Ridge there in the Samoa Basin. That's where we are right now, in 5,000 metres of water. Oof. We are all over the place today. 36 hours out from Tonga. We got the engine on because the wind's all gone. We're now on electric autopilot and the engine, and we're just driving along with a nice rolling swell behind us and lots of power. So nice supper, a couple of beers, and yeah, almost in Tonga. And looking forward to exploring a bit of Tonga, maybe going spear fishing, a bit of free diving, maybe even going and swim with some humpback whales. We shall see, so it's going to be great. But yeah, so it's, what is it, Tuesday, so we're 14 days out, so this trip has taken way longer than it really should have done. But hey, that is sailing. It's a beautiful morning here, about 110 miles off Tonga. It is quite calm, unfortunately. It's only about 9 or 10 knots, but the seas have calmed down enough, so I think we're going to go for the Spinnaker and see whether I can't get some drone footage, which would be awesome. So we've got the electric autopilot on because it's precise whilst I get the Spinnaker up, and then I'll come back and probably do some hand steering and hopefully later get the drone up. Getting some picture of the boat at sea with the Spinnaker up from the drone is a sort of, you know, I've wanted to do that for a long time, and it's a risk in terms of getting the drone back, if I'm frank, but hey, I think it's a risk I want to try and take, so we'll do it on a nice calm morning.
Friday the 21st of October and I'm arriving in Tonga today. I've got the boat set up with a tiny scrap of mainsail and the hydrovane just drifting. You can see I'm just drifting slowly towards the northeast corner of Tonga. I basically don't want to arrive during the night, so I'm crawling along at 2 knots, and the plan is that I'm going to carry on sleeping for another couple of hours until 5 o'clock, which is sunrise, and then I'll get up and start motoring into Tonga. Very excited. It's been a long time coming to get here.
It's 5 o'clock in the morning and a sort of fitful night of sleep, making sure that I didn't run ashore into Tonga overnight, and I've woken up to this stunning dawn. Beautiful dawn coming from the east in the Pacific, and then around you can just see the flat shape of Tonga. Not much elevation. It reminds me of Henderson Island, actually. You've got these sort of square cliffs at either end, but it's good to make a landfall in Tonga.
Time to get the sail down and get the boat ready to arrive in Tonga. I'm going to do this, and then I've got to get the fishing line in, no luck unfortunately, and pull the tow generator up, and then just keep my eyes open because there's supposed to be a lot of humpback whales in this bay, and I just keep an eye open for the diving boats to see if I can get some pictures or maybe get the drone up again. Dive boat over there, and there's a small humpback and a larger whale, I think. Quite difficult trying to get photos of the things though. I decided to leave the whales to it and wend my way up the deep blue shipping channel between Vava'u's islands to the northern capital of Neiafu. As I approached the town's dock, I could see some familiar boats, and the weekly supply ship from the southern capital was in. I set about getting the boat ready to come alongside the steep concrete town dock, a
and to start my entry formalities into the Kingdom of Tonga. My friends Liam and Hillary from Wild Rye, and the whole clan from Aphrodite, had arrived ahead of me. Seeing their friendly faces on the dock after 2 weeks and 1,300 miles at sea, on my own, was a very welcome surprise.
Well, it looks like Liam and little Henry from Aphrodite are going to help me in. Very kind of them. Hi Henry, how you doing? You alright? Scene, thank you very much. Grab this then. Thanks, mate. Thanks, guys.
Our one suggestion.
Yeah.
I don't know if there's enough space, but would be to snuggle up again and tie it.
Yeah, let's walk it forward onto that tire.
Because then you can.
We'll put that tire in the middle.
Yeah, the right.
So let's just. I'm just going to trickle it forward with the engine, guys. Okay, and then we're going to go the tire in the middle. Okay. No, it'll be best that way, I think.
Thank you.
That
was your trip.
Yeah, good, thanks.